फ्रेंड्स नमस्ते। इन दिस सीरीज ऑफ टॉक आई एम प्लानिंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द इश्यूज और डिजीजेस रिलेटेड टू थायराइड एज देर आर मेनी मिसकंसेप्शंस अबाउट दिस पर्टिकुलर ग्लैंड एंड द डिजीजेस एसोसिएटेड। एवरीवन नीड्स टू अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट are the types of diseases and how to tackle them and what to expect when your treatment is going on. This program will be or is being brought to you by Max Clinic, which is my clinic, and Samrohana, which is a cancer foundation which is associated with lot of charitable activities. Thyroid, as you know, is what is called as an endocrine organ, which means it is an organ or a gland which is associated with secretion, some kind of a secretion. Its job is to produce something called as an hormone which is required for the functioning of the body. So this gland is situated right in front of the neck, and it is there in everyone. So it is wrong to say when you have a thyroid disease, it is wrong to say, you know, I have thyroid. You actually have thyroid problem, because when a patient comes to me and sits in front of me, very often they tell me, doctor, I have thyroid. Now that's a very, very wrong way to tell. You should be telling that you have thyroid problem. So this is an organ, it's a butterfly shaped, you can see here, it's a butterfly shaped organ in front of your neck. The structure which you are seeing behind here is the structure that you see here is what is called as trachea or the windpipe. And it is hugging the windpipe on both the sides. So that is how a thyroid is situated. Now what does it do? As I told you earlier, its function is to secrete. The main things that it secretes is what is called as thyroid hormone, and medically we call it T3, T4. So what is the function of this? These two hormones, they basically are involved in the use of energy in the body. It is required for producing heat, it is required for various other purposes and functions of the body. It is required for digestion, it is required for heart, it is required for muscle contraction, where it is involved in the energy that is generated there. It is required for health of the bone, healthy bone, and also in children it is required for development of the nervous system, the intelligence. So when the hormone levels are down, the person becomes dull. That is when it is called hypothyroidism. Also there are other hormones which are secreted. One of them is what is called as calcitonin, that is required mainly for the calcium. Its job is for maintaining the balance of calcium in the body, along with organ called parathyroid, which is right behind the thyroid gland, and together they are involved in the areas where calcium is used. So this is by far the function of thyroid gland. And when we talk about diseases of thyroid, there are many, many diseases. In fact, this is a very broad classification which are given here, which actually groups it into 6 groups. But under each one of these, there are multiple reasons, multiple criteria to be understood. So these are not diseases, you cannot classify and say, you know, I have a thyroid problem. Thyroid problem requires further definition. We need to understand more about it. Now, what is hyperthyroidism? Hyperthyroidism is an hyperfunctioning of the gland. It is working more than it is required. It is producing more than it is required. So, the symptoms are very, very different. There will be tremors. Patient will be very hyperactive. And there are many, many different types of hyperthyroidisms which we really need to understand and understand the treatment if you want to know. That will come later on. When it is hypothyroidism, which is a very, very common thing in among people, whenever a person says, I have a thyroid problem, most of the times it is the hypothyroidism which is the concern. This is a low functioning of the thyroid gland. It is functioning suboptimally. So because it is functioning suboptimally, there is another product called TSH that goes very, very high. So a TSH being high is an indicator of hypothyroidism, which means thyroid is not functioning very well. So generally what we do for this is we replace the thyroid hormone, and that is, you know, we give some tablet which will replace the hypofunctioning gland. We are basically giving the hormone itself. Thyroiditis, which is the third one which is mentioned here, is a swelling of the thyroid gland itself. It is swollen, like, you know, any organ, any area of your body, if you hit it very hard or if you get an injury, it swells up. Like that only thyroid also swells up, but the reasons could be different. There can be an infection in that, there can be inflammation in that. So that is thyroiditis. Again, there are many reasons why thyroiditis can develop. It is not, you know, we cannot specify over here. Goiter is a general term which is used for a visibly enlarged gland. You see it, people sitting with a large gland in front of their neck, that is a goiter. So goiter can be many things. There is something called multinodular goiter, where the thyroid gland itself has cysts, multiple cysts because of the degeneration. So that kind of goiter is the most common form of goiter. There can be other forms, you know, of thyroid nodules where single nodules are there, like, you know, one single swelling. In fact, single nodule in the goiter, again called as adenoma, or it can be multiple other reasons for it. So that's another terminology. And lastly, thyroid cancer, cancers of thyroid, which are also one of the common diseases. So thyroid cancers are cancers arising inside the gland, thyroid gland, and these are one of the most curable cancers. Most of them are can be perfectly cured. In fact, very often thyroid cancer cannot be differentiated from other forms of swellings of thyroid, and we generally end up treating quite a good number of thyroid nodules because there is no differentiation between the two, and the treatment is same as other nodules of thyroid. It's not much different. So that is a broad thing about thyroid gland. I will be going into few of the other details in this series as we go on. So keep watching and subscribe. Thank you.